In this video, I will show you what functions in JavaScript are and how to use them. What a function is. A function is a sub-program that performs a specific task. Typically, in JavaScript, you will have a script, so a file that contains JavaScript, and it will have a lot of different variables, something we've already talked about, but also functions that calculate, that print, or process data in some other way. On screen, you see a very simple function. Now, before we can use a function, we have to write it or declare it, so, you know, to define what it actually does. Declaring functions. Here we see how we can declare a function. We start out with the function keyword. I mentioned this in a previous video. Keywords are words, terms that are specific to JavaScript and that we can only use for that thing that they were created for, and function we use to declare a function. Then the function name. Now this is up to me how I want to name this. Then, very important, parentheses. Then we have curly brackets, and whatever's written within those curly brackets, that's my function block. So that's the code that will be executed when my function runs. Now, there could be multiple things happening in this function that we're creating. The one we're seeing here now on screen does one thing and one thing only. It returns the string, "Hi, nice to meet you." How does it know what to return, especially if it's doing multiple things? Well, that's where the return keyword comes in, okay? The function can only return one thing. In this case, it's a string. Parameters. Sometimes a function needs a little bit more information so that it can run properly or so that it can be reusable. And that's what we use parameters for. Have a look at this function, the greet. Obviously, you don't want to write a function for every possible name. Well, instead, you say, okay, I'm going to take in the information of name and simply use that together with the string of "Hi, nice to meet you." So we're taking in information. By the way, side note, there's also a second way to create functions. These are arrow functions. That's what you're seeing here on screen. They're technically slightly different, so there are certain situations where one is superior to the other. I will be sticking to the conventional way of writing functions during this video. But also here, you see that name there, that is the parameter that is then used within the function. Once we've declared a function, we can run it or invoke it. On the left side, we see our greet function. It does not take in a parameter, so it does not take additional information. Instead, it just returns "Hi, nice to meet you." And we run this function by simply writing the name of the function and parentheses, semicolon, and there you go. Now on the right side, we see how it looks when we run a function that has a parameter, in this case, name. For such situations, and this is crucial, you don't write name in when you're running the function. Instead, you write the value that's supposed to be stored in that name variable. In this case, it could be greet Jane, greet Sarah, greet Boris, whatever we want to pass in, okay? So that name variable, you only write it when you declare it. When you run the function, you pass in the actual value. Return value. Now, I mentioned before that every function needs a return value, and it only can give back one thing. And here's an example to explain that. In pick1, our function, we have three different variables that we're creating, that we're declaring and assigning a value to. But we're only giving back alpha, meaning that when we run the pick1 function, as we see in the second last line, what will it give us back? Well, it will give us back first letter in the Greek alphabet because that is what is stored in the variable of alpha. But that's a bit of a problem because what if you have a function that has to give you back multiple things? I can only run this return value once because what effectively happens running or reading through the code, it reaches return alpha and then it exits the function. So even if there were 3-4 return values beneath that return alpha, they would never run. Well, that's where we can do something like this. You could have a variable that contains an object, and then you could return that. So in this case, if we were now to run our pick one, we would get back an object containing alpha, beta, gamma. Now, objects is something we haven't touched on yet, and there's a reason for that, because the next video is going to be about objects, what they are, how to use them, and also why to use them. I think this is a good example of why you might want to use objects in certain situations. If you've learned anything in this video, then please go ahead and leave us a like, and please also do subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our JavaScript videos.